So we will have a recorded sessions about the modifying commands. So those are the move, copy, rotate, mirror, trim, and fillet. Okay, so we have only 6. Yung iba, the stretch, scale, arrays, and yung iba pang modify commands will be discussed on a later chapter. So we will have first yung mga importanteng modify commands, which are the move, copy, rotate, mirror, trim, and fillet. Okay, so let's start with that. Okay, so I'm just going to have here a new drawing area. Okay, so I'm going to proceed first on the CAD lecture. So if you notice, the CAD lecture start from rectangle commands because last meeting we skipped this one, or we omit to discuss this. This is under geometric entry also. This is rectangle. So instead of using lines, so you're going to use how many lines? 1, 2, 3, 4. You just use rectangle command. All you need to do is to take note of the x coordinate or the horizontal distance, which is 11.5 in this example, then 9.6 yung vertical. So let's try that here using rectangle. So all you need to do is to click this rectangle, then click on your lower left corner, and then give the x and y component, and be sure na yung dynamic input is naka-on. Okay, so let's start. What is 11.5 comma, what is the other one? So let's check it. That is 9.6. okay, so that is again, so we have a rectangle lower left, then yung x component 11.5 comma 9.6. so that is the two figures that you're going to enter. Yung 11.5 is the x component, while yung 9.6 is your y component, and press enter. Okay, so this is now your rectangle. Okay, so we repeat it here. Okay, so just click rectangle, click on the lower left corner. Ang movement niya pag ganyan, if it is positive, pag negative yung component, pag ganito yung movement niya. So let's have yung x component, that is 11.5, then comma 9.6. Okay, that's it. Then press enter. So you have now a rectangle symbol. Okay, the next thing you are going to do is to fillet the corner. Okay, so you're going to fillet each corner. Yung command dito are F. So ganito yung command. Just type F, enter, R, enter, then yung radius. Let's say the radius of this is, let's say, 1. So we're going to type 1, then enter. All you need to do is to click the two adjacent sides. So for example, this one. Yan. So that is the fillet radius, having 1 as the radius of the given. Okay, let's repeat that. Let's say again, F, enter, R, enter, and this time we change the radius, we say 2, enter, then click the 2 adjacent side. So magkaiba yung radius nila, eto is 1, eto yung 2 yung radius. So let's say here is 3 yung radius, so let's try it again. F, enter, R, enter, then 3 is for the radius, and enter. Okay, so click this 2, yung dalawang adjacent. So dito naman, sabihin natin yung radius is 4. So F, enter, R, enter, then the new radius, which is 4, then press enter, then click on the two adjacent side. Okay, so that is now how to use fillet command. Paano kung uniform yung radius? If the radius is uniform, you can do this. This is much faster compared to the first example wherein you have different radius. Kung para pareho lang naman yung radius, you can do this. That is F, enter, M, enter. Then, do not forget the R, enter, then yung uniform radius. So, let's say yung uniform radius is 2.5. Then, press enter. So, all you need to do, yung last step nyo is i-click nyo lang yung adjacent corner. Yan. These two. The third corner. And the last one. So, that is how we use the fillet multiple. Ayan, yun ang fillet multiple reduce. Okay. So, now we have this. If are you having hard time during your exercise number 1A or 1B to put a circle here, so all you need to do is to use it's either center radius or center diameter, depende sa given. So let's say center radius, then para makuha mo yung center ng arc na to, all you need to do is to pass this arc. Pag dinaanan nyo siya, lalabas yung center mark dito. So, i-click mo na lang yan dyan. Then, give the radius. Let's say, 1 yung radius. Ganon. So, let's say we repeat that process here. Okay? That is center radius. Daanan yung arc. Then, lalabas yung center point dito. Then, give the radius. Okay? Can you repeat it again? For the last 2 times. So, daanan. Then, lalabas yung center mark. Click it. Then, give the radius. Yan. And the last time, at si diameter naman, center diameter. So, pass this arc, then lalabas yung center mark. Click that one, then give the radius. Let's say yung diameter pala. Let's say yung diameter is 2, then press enter. Okay, so that is how we create yung similar figure dito sa exercise. Ito po yun. Oh. Iba lang yung given. So, yung ginagamit natin yung object stop setting. Okay? So now, let's continue yung mga remaining modify commands. So we have the move, we have the copy, we have the rotate, mirror, trim, and we are done now with fillet. So this is the command for fillet, and this is the command for fillet multiple. So meron na tayo nitong example, then we proceed to the move. Paano naman yung move commands? Okay, so let me give you an example on how to move. First, yung ito yung step or yung example. If you can see, nag-move yung object from here and dito yung destination. So how do you move it properly? So ganito. So hanapin na muna natin yung origin. Okay? So malayo kasi yung so ayan, ayun. Ito na yung origin, ito yung object natin. Napakaliit, so i-move ko muna dito na malapit sa origin. Okay. So let's say you will have here a circle. So, you have two ways on how to move your object. It is either if yung destination mo is hindi naman kailangan accurate, all you need to do is to move it para maalis yung mga nakasagabal dun sa drawing area mo, you can do that by simply pressing M, enter, select the object, enter, base point kahit saan. So, later I will going to show you kung ano ang base point. Then, click kayo kung saan mo siya ilalagay. So, halimbawa nandun. Paano kung accurate yung position? Kung accurate yung position, ganito. Kailangan mo munang i-off yung dynamic input, which is this one. Pag na-off mo na yung dynamic input, ang sunod mong gagawin is move command. Move, enter, then select the object, which is this one. Yan. You can either click this one for selection or you can box it using this method. Okay? So, let's say we box it, then press enter kung tapos na kayo mag-select ng object. Next is, hanapin nyo yung base point. Saan ito ahawak? Itong crosshair na to. Saan ba yun nahahawak? So, let's say sa center. So, i-click nyo yung center. Okay? So, next, gusto nyo ilagay dito sa origin. Ang ito-type nyo lang dun sa command line is 0, 0. That is because 0, 0 is the coordinate of the origin. Then press enter. Ayun, nag-move na dun yung circle mo. Kung gusto mo siyang i-move sa another coordinates, all you need to do is to retry or redo moves. So M, enter, select object, enter, then base point sa gitna ulit. Okay, ito yung base point. Dun nakahawak yung crosshair mo, then yung coordinates kung saan mo siya i-move. Let's say this time 10, 10. Okay, so that is your new position of the circle. Then press enter. Ayun, nandito na yung center niya. So this is 10, 10. So nandito siya. Okay, next naman is, let's say, you have here a circle. Ito po. Yan. And this circle, you want to move it on top of this circle. Okay, so madali lang siya. Ang gawin nyo lang is move ulit. Enter. Select object. Okay, ayun. Sinelect natin. Enter. Yung base point, saan tayo hawak? Dito po sa quadrant. Lumabas yung diamond, then may lumabas na quadrant na label. I-click nyo yan, then dahan-dahan yung i-move sa quadrant din ng circle na yun. Dapat lumabas yun. Ayun, i-click nyo. Then accurately, na-move natin yung circle going dun sa maliit na circle. So that is how we use move. Okay? So delete ko na muna to. Then let's have yung second, yung copy. So, halimbawa, mayroon tayong object. Yung dalawang step is, let's say you have a circle here, then you want to copy that. All you need to do is to type CO, enter, select the object, enter, kahit saan kayo mag-base point. Kung gusto nyo lang naman magkaroon ng copy ng given object. Okay? Yun ang isang way kung paano mag-copy dun sa drawing area. Pero kung gusto siyang accurate, let's say this one, gusto niyong ilagay sa 0, 0, same thing na gagawin natin, copy, or you can just click this, select object, enter, then yung base point, halimbawa doon, then i-type niyo ulit yung coordinates. So for this example, you have 0, 0. So pupunta yan doon, pero hindi ito maaalis kasi copy nga, hindi naman move. Okay? Another thing is, let's say, yung circle mo is gusto mong maggumawa ng copy dito on the right side. So, dapat by quadrant. So, check nyo yung importance ng base point. So, ito yung importance ng base point. Kung magka-copy kayo ng object going to the right, dapat yung base point niya nandito sa left. So, ipapakita ko. That is copy. So, that is CO. Select object. So, ito, select ko siya. Enter. Saan ako mag-base point? Dito. Why? Kung dito ako mag-base point, so i-move ko na lang yan dyan. Okay, automatic. Doon sa quadrant din. So, accurate siya. So, wala kayong problema. Pag sa gitna kasi kayo nag-copy, so ulitin ko ah. Pag sa gitna kayo nag-base point, select object, then enter. Then, kung sa gitna kayo nag-base point, so yung position doon sa quadrant, sa gilid, hindi nyo ma-target accurately. So, mag-i-estimate kayo. So, it may be, zoom natin, it may be overlapping or hindi siya nag-intersect. Yeah, hindi siya nag-intersect. So, mali yung step natin. So, be careful in choosing your base point. So, again, this is the right way. CO, enter, select object, enter, select your base point. So, that is on the quadrant on the left side. And you're going to click the quadrant on the right side. So, ganun lang ang pag-copy. So, kung pataas naman, CO, enter, select the entire circles, then enter. Saan yung base point? Dito sa baba. Then, ipipaste mo siya dun sa base, yung quadrant sa taas. Yun. So, we have now a circle copy. So, 4x4 lang siya. 4x4 na siya. So, hindi na kayo gumawa ng maraming step sa circles. Okay? So, that is the copy command. Yung rotate naman, madali lang yung rotate. So, gawa tayo ng square na 4x4. Yun, 4, 4. Ah, sorry. So, i-on nyo ulit yung dynamic input para hindi siya mag-proceed dun sa coordinate na 4x4. Kasi yung target natin is mahagawa lang ng 4x4 na square. Then, lagyan natin ng diagonal para makita natin yung effect ng rotation. So, ito yung effect ng rotation. So, ika-copy ko to ng, let's say, ilang kopya. So, apat sila. Ito yung original. Ito, i-rotate natin by 30 degrees. Ito, i-rotate natin by 45 degrees. I-rotate natin by 60 degrees. So, ganito lang yung step. RO, enter. Then, ito yung object. Select mo siya. Enter. Then, base point ulit. Ano yung base point sa rotation? Ang base point sa rotation, that is the pivot point. So, ganyan siya iikot. So, kahit anong angle ang nilagay mo, ganyan ang mga appearance niya. So, ibig sabihin, yung center mo, parang nandun yung screw mo na hindi, yun lang ang point na hindi gagalaw. So, for this example, sabi natin, yung angle natin is for 30. So, ito yung angle 30. That is the rotate the square by 30. Ito naman, i-rotate natin. RO, enter. Select object, enter. Then, dito yung again yung base point. 45 naman ang gamitin natin. So, 45, that is the rotation angle. Yan. So, umiikot siya by 45 degrees. Ito naman, last space is 60. So, RO, enter. Select object, enter. Dito yung base point. Then, 60. So, you have 60 degrees yung rotation. Yun. Umiikot siya ng 60 degrees. So, paano kung mali, kung iba naman yung base point? Ganito yung rotation. Papakita ko. Let's say, RO, enter, select object. Kung dito kayo naglagay ng base point, dyan siya iikot, di ba? So, nakikita nyo naman yung output. So, ito mga possible output ng square nyo. Kung i-cancel ko ulit yung rotate command, then ulitin natin. Kung dito naman yung base point mo, so dyan siya iikot. Okay, depende sa application kung saan kayo maglalagay ng rotation. Kung magro-rotate lang ng kayo na hindi siya part ng isang object, so walang problema kahit saan kayo mag-base point. Pero kung part siya ng isang object or isa lang siyang piece ng isang malaking plates, kailangan yung ma-target yung tamang base point. So, that is the rotate. Then, we have now the trim. Paano yung trim? Halimbawa, meron tayong lines dito. Yan, gawa mo na kung ordinary rectangle. Then, lumampas. Then, kung ayaw nyo na mag-ulit, kasi kung uulit, it will going to take time. Ang gagawin nyo na lang is to trim it. So, paano mag-trim? Ito yun, TR, enter. Select object, enter ulit. Then, you can now trim it. Yun, yan, trim na siya. Diba? So, kahit marami siya, so try natin maraming object. Ito. Okay. So, ito yung mga object mo. Then, yung mga excess, ititrim natin. So, paano pag-trim yan? That is TR, enter, enter. So, ikiklik nyo lang yung mga excess na curves and line. Ganun lang. Kahit i-box nyo siya, as long as tamaan nyo. Okay? So, pwede naman click kung beginner pa lang, isa-isa lang. So, walang problema. So, active pa yan. So, as long as hindi ka mag-escape, pwede makatrim ng ibang part ng object mo. So, halimbawa, ito tinamaan mo, na-trim siya. Yun, tinamaan mo din, na-trim siya. So, kailangan mong escape or enter. So, ipapress ko na yung escape para makancel yung trim command. So, ganun lang pag-trim. Pwede naman ito, kung ito gagamitin nyo, ang gawin nyo lang, pag-click nyo ng trim commands here, press enter. Then, select object to trim. Basta nakita nyo yan sa drawing area nyo, you can now use trimming. So, left-click na siya. Okay? So, ganun lang. So, that is trim command. So, next is mirror. So, paano naman ang mirror? Ganito yung mirror. Halimbawa, may rectangle tayo dito or triangle. Then, kikreate tayo ng symmetric object sa left side, sa right side niya dito. So, you can use mirror. Just type MI, enter, select object. Ito lang dalawa para hindi siya makakreate ng duplicate nito. Then, press enter. Then, i-click nyo to, yung mirror line. Yan. Tapos, ito. Kasi dyan siya magre-reflect. Dyan siya iikot. Then, erase source objects. So, no. Para hindi naman mawala ito. Then, press enter. Okay. Paano kung pababa? Kung pabababa naman siya, MI, enter, select the object, enter, then ito yung mirror line. Eto, pwede naman hanggang dito, pwede hanggang lang dito. So, the same yung output yan. So, hanggang lang dito, then, no ulit, press enter. Yun, ganun. Ganun lang ang mirror. Okay pa? Kahit yung mirror mo is medyo malayo, as long as you have the yung reflection lines or rotation angle, kailangan, yun lang i-click nyo. So, halimbawa, meron tayo ditong rectangle ulit, then hindi siya magro-rotate along dito sa vertical niya. Let's say, may line dito, even though imaginary siya pwede. Halimbawa, eto, i-create ng another object on the right side. So, all you need to do is to type MI, that is short for mirror, select object, enter, then yung mirror line nyo, eto yung line na to. So, i-click nyo yung first endpoint, then the second endpoint, then press enter. Okay? So, that is how we use mirror line. Okay? So, tapos na tayo. Fillet and ano pa? Wala na ba? So, move, rotate, trim. Okay na. Copy, mirror, and fillet. So, that's it for your modify commands. So, all of your tutorial keys or commands are here. Okay, so you can just visit the Google Docs. So rectangle, modify, start from, fillet, move, copy, rotate, mirror, trim, and you have now the exercise number 2. So ito yung mga reminder for EL, BL, CL, and so on. Okay, so that's it for the recording.